Well, we're still getting a lot of new information about the whole Jeffrey Epstein saga. Just this morning, we found out that the two guards who were supposed to be checking on him instead decided to just take a nap together for about 3 hours and falsify their records to make it seem like, oh, we did check on him, but really we were just having a little buddy snooze. But a really interesting detail emerged late yesterday when it was revealed that a post on 4chan actually announced Epstein's death and quite a few details about his death prior to the public announcement by ABC News via Twitter. Here's what happened. This was 38 minutes before ABC News tweeted out that Epstein was found dead. The post appeared on 4chan by an anonymous user. People were questioning. They didn't know if they should believe this person or not. And so they got the original poster to post a little more, you know, divulge a little more information. Where this poster described the resuscitation methods that they attempted on Jeffrey Epstein, which included telemetry, where they administered sodium bicarbonate to counteract all the acid that built up in his bloodstream as a result of prolonged cardiac arrest, which means Epstein had been dead for quite a while, or at least heart dead. His heart had stopped for quite a while before they found the body. Now, according to this person who says they then administered this, they did it for about 40 minutes, then they took the body to the hospital where they tried for another 20 minutes to revive him. This was all posted on 4chan prior to the public knowing about this. So, here's the thing. Obviously, the person who posted this is somebody who was present. Now, the New York City Fire Department has done a quick investigation or review. Sorry, they don't want you to call it an investigation. They did a review and they've determined from their review that it wasn't anybody in their office. No, nobody with the fire department's office. Still could have been a first responder, could have been a guard at the jail, could have been anyone who was present at the time. But obviously, and here's my own little twist to this, obviously, as I pointed out, somebody's starting to leak stuff. They leaked this before the public knew about it. And I think we could get more leaks in the future. And I hope we do. I don't look at this as a negative thing. I know 4chan is, not the most reputable site. It's got plenty of normal people on there and plenty of hate-filled people on there. But this was neither, right? This was somebody who wanted to get this information out. And they likely have more information to get out as well. And if they don't, somebody else there does. But again, and I'm gonna gloat a little bit, because I took a lot of crap from people saying, nobody's gonna leak this stuff. Well, guess what, folks? They already did. And hopefully there's more to come. Because this is what we need. We're not going to get a real story out of the U.S. Department of Justice here. We're not. We know that. We're not foolish enough or naive enough to believe that they're gonna tell us what actually happened. So this is the best course of action for people who have information. You know, use a VPN if you need to so they can't track your IP and trace you back to a work computer. Do it from your house if you need to with a VPN. Maybe borrow a friend's computer. I don't care what it is. Tell us what happened. Release the information. Release the tapes if you can get your hands on those files. Because the public needs to know what happened to Jeffrey Epstein. Thanks for watching, everybody. And don't forget, if you like what you see here, like, comment, share, and subscribe to our channel. And now you can also become a member of Ring of Fire and get exclusive early access to certain Ring of Fire videos all throughout the week. Just click on the little join button right below the video.